President Marcos visits Camarines Sur as parts of the province still underwater days after Christine's onslaught. Let's get the latest in Camarines Sur from our correspondent, Jesse Cruzat. Jesse.
Yes, good afternoon, Rica. It has been 2 days of good weather here in Camarines Sur, but many areas remain submerged in floodwaters. President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. and Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro Jr. talked to the rescuers during their visit in Barangay Kausip Bula, Camarines Sur on Saturday. Vehicles are still stranded along a section of Maharlika Highway in San Fernando, Camarines Sur, although the flood had has slightly receded. Many areas in Agi City and nearby towns are still flooded, including the municipalities of Milaor, Minalabac, Gainza, Camaligan, Canaman, and others. In the town of Minalabac, residents trapped on the roofs of their houses are using various strategies. Some have temporarily relocated to 3 houses. They have nowhere else to go since even the evacuation centers have also been flooded. In the town of Bula, rescuers had to use boats to reach areas where the floodwaters are still above head height. Many people remain trapped on the roofs of their houses. In Gainza, some areas have yet to be reached by rescuers, prompting residents to call for assistance as many of them have run out of food and water supplies. Rescue and relief operations continue in many barangays in Naga City. However, Rica, the local government admits that they still cannot reach all affected areas. The Philippine Red Cross made efforts to transport patients from San Fernando to Naga City. Some of these patients are children and some are dialysis patients. Right now, the residents of Camarines Sur have no other appeal but for help and assistance. Residents urgently need various essentials such as proper clothing, food, drinkable water, and medicine. Meanwhile, farmers are also facing issues with their damaged crops, particularly rice that was affected by the massive floodings. Meanwhile, as of yesterday's report from the Philippine National Police, the devastation caused by Storm Christine in the Bicol region has left 29 people dead, 9 injured, and 4 missing. The fatalities include 1 drowning incident in Camarines Norte, 3 in Camarines Sur, and 1 in Sorsogon, and also 12 in Naga City, while landslides caused 4 deaths in Albay and Catanduanes. And that's the latest from my end. Back to you, Rica.
Hi, Jesse. Just one question. You mentioned earlier that there are areas that are still haven't been haven't been able to reach by rescue authorities. Would you know if they have communication with these areas, or are those only because they are in flooded regions?
Yes, Rica, that's right. There are still a lot of areas that are still flooded, and rescuers cannot penetrate them as of this moment because of the level of the flood. But we have here the line of communication. The line of communication, including some, you know, internet connection, are all active. But the main problem is that residents cannot go outside their houses because they are still trapped on the roof. So they are calling for help from the rescuers, including those who have speedboats or other vessels that can penetrate to their area, so they can already get food and other help from the government.
All right, thank you so much, Jesse Cruzat, reporting live.